Hello children, how are you all? I hope everybody is fine. And then after 2 days, I'm posting my video today. Okay, so we are going to just learn here about the morphology. Actually, we finished off morphology. In that morphology, many of the modifications of root, stem, leaf and then flower we learned in the previous sessions. Now let me show you how actually the flower arrangement and then stem, actually those all thing will be there. Here we are going to learn about the only a twig of hibiscus. This is a twig of hibiscus, children, and this twig will be containing leaf, bud, flower, everything I am going to focus today. Okay, this is a stem. What we call, actually this is the stem axis. Okay, and these are the nodes I will be focusing here. This is actually the node. Okay, from the node region, what happens, always there will be arising of the leaf. And when we are talking about the leaf structure, we discussed about a small appendage. The small appendage, the small leafy-like appendage which arises at the bottom of the leaf, that is called what? Stipule. Now, this is what? This is the stipule, children. This one is stipule, okay? I hope everybody is clearly can observe. This is the stipule, okay? Now, this is the node region. This is also one more node. And the place between two nodes, the gap between two nodes is called what? Internode. This is node, this is also node, this is the internode, this is the stipule. Okay, when we go across at the axis, there will be many of the buds. See, these are the leaf primordias and these are the buds. See, these all are the buds. Okay, now let me tell you about very briefly about the leaf. See, we discussed very neatly about the leaf in the sessions, last sessions. This is what actually the structure of the leaf will be, and at the base of the leaf there will be leafy like appendage which is called stipule. Like I said, if stipule is there, then at the base, okay. And in some of the plants, what happens, there will be a bud, okay. At the junction there will be bud, at the axis of the leaf there will be bud, and that bud is called what? Leaf bud, or else axial bud. I can say, I will be showing you just a minute. See, at the tip, if you clearly observe here, if you are able to observe very clearly, here there is a bud, okay, this one, okay, where I kept my finger. This is actually bud, children, okay. Now let me show you the parts of the flower, okay. There are three parts, okay, in the section of the leaf only we discussed about that. What are those three? One is petiole, one more is lamina, the next is about leaf lamina, and then the veins, okay. See, this is the petiole. Stalk of the leaf is called what? Petiole, okay. The stalk of the leaf is called petiole, and then extended part of the leaf is called leaf lamina. And leaf lamina, leaf margin may be wavy, smooth, that we will depend on them. And if you observe very neatly, these all are about the veins, okay. The main vein is this one. This is called midrib. This is called what? This is the midrib, children. And this midrib, veins and veinlets, if you observe very clearly, there are veinlets also. Small nerve-like structures are there. These all are veins and then veinlets. As the veins and then veinlets are making network-like area, network-like structure, that's what this is called. Which kind of venation? Yes, reticulate venation. Okay, this is about the leaf, children. You can see very clearly there is a marginal leaf margin is there, and then this is all about the leaf. Okay, what actually I wanted to show you is here the buds. Okay, this is the bud, leaf bud, sorry, flower bud. Okay, flower bud, when the flower is going to be bloom, then there will be the arising of the flower. See here, it is little bit, it is growing, isn't it? This is first. When after few days, what happens? The same bud will be showing you the further growth. Okay, now tell me what actually the flower stalk is called. Stalk of the flower is called what? Yes, you should comment me. Okay, stalk of the flower, what it is called. Okay, and see here, this is the root, shoot apex. This is all apex, where there will be the terminal buds will be there. These all are about the terminal buds. Here there will be terminal buds. These all are about terminal buds, and young leaves are there, young buds are there, everything you can see. Okay, now let me show you how actually the flower and flower parts are, because in recent sessions we finished off about the four whorls of the flower, isn't it? So we are going to discuss about the flower. How many whorls are there, children, for the flower? Yes, of course I told you about the flower. See, this is the hibiscus flower I brought for you. Okay, see, as this is only one flower which is present at the tip of the plant, that's what it is called, solitary inflorescence. Okay, there is no clusters of the flower, so this is solitary inflorescence. If you observe very keenly, you can see at the end of the what? At the end of the stalk of the flower. I won't say what actually the stalk of the flower is. Okay, so at the end of the stalk of the flower, you can see again the leafy appendage. This is different. This is stipule. Okay, at the base of the petiole, if leaf is there, then it is called petiole. If this one at the base of the stalk of the flower, if leafy like appendage is there, then it is called what? Bract. Exactly. Now this is the bract, children. Okay, now there is a long petiole, I can say. Okay, this is all about the long petiole. Okay, now let me show you each and every part of this flower. Now see, this is the stalk of the flower. Stalk of the flower is called what? Petiole. Okay, see children, this is about the petiole, and there are four whorls. I said first whorl, calyx, which will be green in color. Next is about corolla, which is very very colorful, and this is about androecium, and this is the gynoecium. Here today we are going to learn each and every part. Okay, now let me show you what actually the calyx is. And this one, the bulged portion, the swollen portion is there. Now this swollen portion is nothing but the thalamus. On this swollen portion, this is petiole. On the petiole, at the tip of the petiole, there will be swollen portion which is called thalamus. Okay, on this thalamus there will be arrangement of oval arrangement of calyx, corolla, androecium, and then gynoecium. Okay, now see, I am tearing this flower. First whorl I am going to remove here. I am just removing the first whorl, that is the calyx. Okay, this is about the calyx. See, I removed the calyx. This is what actually the calyx looks like. Okay, now let us show for the next, that is about the corolla. These all are the petals, which we can call, unit of corolla is called petals. First petal, second, third, fourth, and fifth. These all are about the petals. Okay, during the flower session, we discussed what calyx and corolla are non-essential whorl because they are not directly involving in the sexual reproduction. Okay, now see, if flower is containing calyx or corolla, it doesn't matter, okay, because it is not at all directly involving in the reproduction. So that these two, the calyx and the corolla, are called what? Non-essential whorls. Let me, okay, now this is about the, now the next whorl is androecium. Here in the hibiscus, what happens, the androecium will be fused, means there will be two parts for the androecium, one is filament, another one is the stamen. Okay, the stamen and then filament. Here what happens, children, that is some of the modification, the stamen is fused. So I am going to show you, okay, this all are about the stamen. This is the third whorl, children, that is about the androecium. This is the third whorl, okay, which one I am going to take it off. I am taking off the third whorl of the flower, that is the stamen. And then next we come across with the fourth whorl, that is gynoecium. Okay, see, here you can very clearly can observe, this is the androecium, this is the gynoecium. Again, the androecium is having the very minute one, which is called stamen. These are the stamens, and these all are what? Filaments. Overall structure is called androecium. And when we talk about the this one gynoecium, then it will be having, this is what, this is overall structure is what? Gynoecium. This is stigma, style, and then ovary. Here inside this ovary, what happens, there will be presence of ovule, children. In later session you will be going to learn about that. Okay, this is the female reproductive part, and then this is the male reproductive part. Male reproductive part is called androecium, female reproductive part is called what? Gynoecium. Female reproductive part shows three parts. First one, stigma, style, the long pipe-like style, and then the bulged swollen portion, ovary. Here there will be the fertilization process. About this we are going to learn in the next session. Now let me show you one more flower. Okay, this is all about the hibiscus. Let me keep all the four whorls, and then in detail we are going to talk about. These all are the four whorls, okay, calyx, corolla, androecium, and then gynoecium. Okay, sorry for the disturbance. Calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. Okay, if I say only one unit, then this is only one petal. If it is in a circular manner, then it is called corolla. Okay, I hope everybody is clear about this. One more flower example I am going to give you here.